have a vertical rotary saw on it. It's actually spinning in the opposite direction than the conventional direction, which is down. It's spinning up so that if it catches something, it'll flip it over, right, as well as cutting it. This tread's on the bottom, so you can do a quick turn. So you just, one tread goes this way, the other tread goes, and it just turns on point. It took a couple hours to build the motor mount, and I spent a lot of time making sure that that's the way I wanted it to be, because that's the most crucial part of the robot. Without that, it's just the box driving around. The circuitry is on this level, so basically on the underside of this. So that way you can break it apart, and it's in different components, easier to work with.
I went for all-out armor, hoping that no one would actually be able to do damage to me, which was kind of right. I mean, I took a few nicks, but other than that, it stayed solid. Like any engineering, there's a lot of math, a lot of science. Pretty much everything you do is considered critical thinking.
Well, the students who run competitive robotics come from all different backgrounds. We've had computer scientists, mechanical engineers, electrical engineers, civil engineers get involved too. The thing about engineering students is that they learn fairly quickly that they have to be not only well-versed individually in a lot of subjects, but they have to be able to work with a lot of different people. So the interdisciplinary nature of the Competitive Robotics Club is a real value to them in terms of their experience and how they're going to use the different those different interpersonal relationships in the future.
You know, I especially like the idea of exploratory robots, so like robots that use legs to get around. But I sort of have a community service side to me. So I also kind of like, and I'm attracted to the idea of orthotics and prosthetics as well. So sort of robotics applied to the human motion, you know, it's a fascinating thing.
Well, what it can do right now is follow at a constant distance with this, and with this it can follow a black line on the floor anywhere it goes.
I think both of them emit sound in an ultrasonic that we can't hear, and then they also detect the reflection of the sound. So it's just like a dolphin or a sonar.
One of the best parts about it is they have such an exciting product that's accessible to all sorts of people, from young people, like little kids, to old people. And that's part of the reason why it's such a dynamic organization, because they get to actually connect with the community.